Hello, I'm Gutsy. In today's video, I'll be sharing a little bit more about how I improved my physics score from a 3 to a 7 when I was doing the IB. I was the batch that did the November 2018 IB papers, and physics was one of my HR subjects. I scored 43 overall for the IB, and physics was one of the subjects that I got a 7 for. Just to clarify, I really struggled with physics. To begin with, I don't really have a brain wired for this subject, for physics. It's very abstract and often deals with things I can't see or touch. The main reason why I took it at the HR level was because I loved it a lot. I loved the idea of it, but I really struggled to understand the concepts and the way that the scientific method is used and how it works. My struggle was further compounded by the fact that I was struggling to juggle the rest of my subjects on the side, and I didn't really do a lot of my physics homework. And maybe because of that, I didn't understand what was going on in class. I was sleepy all the time, and there was that vicious cycle of trying to catch up with what I missed previously, but then missing the new content that was being taught. I think my struggle with physics and my lack of doing homework really showed in the grades. I started out with about 4s and 5s, which was okay given how I think I wasn't able to do that much work, and given how I had been trying here and there to cover the content which I missed. But I really got a shock when prelims rolled around. I got a 3 from my prelim exams, and I really started to panic. It gave me a big shock. After that, I really set aside a lot of time just to do physics. I had to relearn everything from scratch, especially the weaker topics. I used to work on it in the library every few days or so. I rewrote all my notes, and really just spammed the practice questions. And finally, for the IB, I managed to get a 7. There were a few things that really helped me, and I thought I should share them with you guys. The first thing that really helped me was to do the IB question bank questions. This is the official questions from the past year papers that IB has published. And I think you need to get an official account to access them, but you can try asking your teacher because my school had subscribed to the account, so you don't need to buy a personal one. I did them categorized by topic, and I really spent a lot of time on this. Something I learned the hard way is that you must mark right after you do the questions, if not you'll forget whether you got it right or wrong. Don't delay or you'll end up remembering the wrong answer to be the so-called right one. I find the question bank questions very helpful because you can see the similarities in question types and how they vary the questions. There's the MCQs, the simpler standard questions for each topic, and the more complex questions that require you to use knowledge from multiple topics. These questions, they can be split into many parts, and maybe let's say part A and part B uses one topic, or part C uses another topic and part D and another topic. And so they require you to equate the formulas from across different topics to be able to be familiar and flexible and apply them here and there in multiple creative situations. Firstly, there's the MCQ questions. They are tricky, but the good thing is that they repeat and come out every few years or so, with the numbers slightly tweaked or the concepts tweaked here and there, just like this electron and charge question. So keep practicing until you become familiar with the question type. There are also the simpler standard questions for each topic. For example, the questions on thin film interference, they are quite standard and require to calculate a certain quantity or to derive an equation. These are the questions you shouldn't miss. They're there to help you score points, just practice until you're familiar. Finally, there's the complex questions that you need to put together your knowledge from across multiple topics. The IB physics board can be very creative and wacky and give the most unconventional and weird examples, but it really helps if you've already mastered how to apply the physics principles or laws in the simpler questions before you move on to these harder, more complex questions. Once you're more or less done with the question bank questions by topic, you might want to move on to doing the past year papers, the full-length past year papers under exam conditions. The main goal of this is for you to get used to finishing under the time limit and gain confidence as you see your score improve slowly over time. The second thing that really helped me was to go for consultations with my physics teacher. There are some answers that absolutely don't make sense to me. I never saw the questions in my school textbook, and I had no idea how IB got the answer. Especially in these cases, you should go and consult your teacher. Sometimes my teacher also gets stumped by the questions, especially if it's quite tricky. But she'll go and think of it and get back to us about why the answer is that particular option. So yes, if you can see here, I've circled some of the questions I had that I wanted to ask my teacher in red. And after I consulted her, I wrote down what she said about it and the reasoning behind the answer. But just a note of caution, don't consult your teacher without doing your practices. It's not very productive and can be a waste of your teacher's time. I think it's better if you do the hard work first, then go for consultations to clarify any doubts you have. Finally, the third thing that really helped me was when I finally knew what the symbols and the formulas stand for. I didn't really understand the symbols before this, so I always just sub in quantities randomly and wrongly. It's a bad habit I picked up from earlier, when during my mock exams in my first year of IB, I didn't really have time to study too deeply because of all the other deadlines from all the other subjects. So my method to survive and pass the exam was just to sub in any number I could find, or any number that I thought was the quantity. So if there was a P or there was W, I'll be like, okay, maybe this is W, maybe this is Q, maybe this is P, and just sub it in. But it became an obstacle later, because when it got to the more complex questions, I was completely lost. I was still randomly subbing in numbers and formulas, trying to equate two completely unrelated formulas from completely different spheres of knowledge. I would ask myself, is this I same as the other I? And I would really mess up the questions, and my teacher can tell that I completely don't understand the concepts at all. The biggest thing that really helped me was to make a copy of the formula sheet and annotate each formula, unpacking what the symbols meant and when the formula should be used. When I did that, it helped me see the relationships between the different formulas. I learned about when I can use the formula and when I can't use the formula, and how the formulas can be connected, which will help a lot for the complex questions that require knowledge from across different topics. The main principle behind this is really just to work on understanding, not just randomly subbing in numbers. And yeah, what helped me was annotating the formula sheet. In conclusion, I think I would like to just leave some of my closing tips and some encouragement. I think the main things for tips, I think I've already mentioned them earlier on, but it's really just to do the IB question bank. Secondly, to make sure you're clear about the letters and symbols used in formula. And finally, to consult your teacher. And as for encouragement, I'd just like to encourage you that there is some hope. Back when I was in high school, my cohort generally didn't do so well in the first year of IB. Most of us averaged around 4 or 5, some of us 3s, but we managed to help each other pull up the grade to 6s and 7s by the time IB rolled around. It's okay if you're not good at physics. I think hard work, especially at the IB level, is enough. If you're still at the starting stage of IB, I highly encourage you to learn the concepts well from the beginning. But even if you only have 2 or 3 months left, I think it's still possible. Just do your best. That's it for today's video. I hope my sharing has been helpful for you. Bye bye for now, and see you again in my next video.